Hello everyone and welcome back to Keep Productive News. If you are new to this podcast, please do make sure it's subscribed on Apple Podcasts and Spotify. Now, a new story that many people didn't really see coming is that Google have introduced something called Google Tables, and it was basically built by an incubator within Google called Area 120. And essentially, it's an Airtable competitor aiming to help teams easily track and automate tasks, enabling them to save time and work smarter. And essentially, you can do sort of project management, IT operations, customer tracking, and it's very, very similar to the likes of Airtable in the sense that you can build these sort of different views, you can integrate applications, and you can work off templates. And they do have this sort of feature that sort of stands out, that makes it, I guess, special to some extent, that is called bots. And essentially, you can use these bots to like trigger emails, update statuses, or even send weekly reports, basically automations to some extent. Now, this is a really interesting sort of project. It's currently only available in the US as a beta, and it does already have a pricing plan, which I was surprised at. But I'm guessing in the future, they're probably planning to weave this into G Suite and how that works. It does have a free plan that is obviously $0 per month per user and includes 100 tables, 1,000 rows, and 1 gigabyte attachments, as well as 50 actions and limited history. Whilst the paid plan is $10 per user per month, gives you 1,000 tables, 10,000 rows, and 10 gigabytes per month. And apparently if you sign up through that, you get 3-month free trial. But this is interesting. It seems like Google are sort of taking on the likes of Airtable with this, but I also see them trying to take on apps like Coda, because they've got these different layouts and views that help you to sort of manage projects, change statuses, very much like Coda does. It even has a Kanban view within it to allow you to monitor projects. And very much like Coda, has automations in the form of bots. So it's a very interesting project by this incubator inside of Google. We'll see where it goes. I've been saying for a long time that Google has definitely, definitely should have been sort of working on building Drive, Google Drive, into something like Notion or Coda, or on whether Coda would actually be purchased by Google in the coming months. But let's see. This is an exciting project for now, and something that, whilst in its minimal format, could be a good future for Google as they sort of see the focus on remote work and also on the sort of all-in-one hub workspaces. So guys, that was the news today. Hopefully you found this interesting. Please do make sure to subscribe again to the podcast, and we'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheerio.